I can't make your heart feel same time. It's time for open confession. To lift the things that are pressing and stressing. To bare my soul and get butt booted naked on this stage. I want to allow my emotions to be unclothed. And get intellectually freaking dinky, downright verbal and nasty. It's like I want to be public getting it on, y'all. And sometimes I'm feeling for the next microphone. So I can spit that right poem to make that beautiful sister in the front row smile with the eyes at me and and after all y'all done gone home, I want to hear her moan. So I try real hard to write her up with upliftment and positive movement. To inspire my son to want to pop my vibe in his boombox as he tells his homies, yo, check my old girl CD and believe me. I don't want to offend, but my alter ego tends not to want to bend to what society rules as being cool. So, you know, me and my ego, we flow. She's like my best critic and a real good friend, so I guess it's my luck whenever Sister So What shows up, because it ain't often I get to spit that poem that tells too much about me. But every now and again, I slip a little innuendo in, just to let you know that that beautiful sister in the front row, well, she's wifey. And her smile is precisely why I don't give a damn what nobody's got to say about my sexuality. Because the reality is, yo, she loves me mentally and physically, so your hypocritical finger pointing, don't be getting next to me. But inspire me to encrypt with your minds and nurse your soul back into health and provide your blind eye with the wealth of an open mind. You see, I don't dog dare one of you inferior heads deflect your masculinity in me. So I can show you how I work this microphone, affectionately known as my magic stick. Yeah. And I'm thick with this lyrical gift. And sometimes I can flow on for more than 3 minutes long because my back is strong. I've been wearing the weight of injustice, thought black had my back, but fat got my inside jacked with eyes like mine to prejudge me. Believe it, my validity lies on who I'm doing. But you can love me and love me not. But I'm as serious as India, I read when I say that God ain't make no mistakes on me.
That's right.
So I intend to infringe on your psyche, like a well-read book can tell you take the time to look at what's inside of me. You see, it's my individuality that can part minds and thighs at the same time. Still, I managed to leave you shook, because your girl just left her phone number in my phone book. I'm chock full of none of positivity. But it ain't but so much, sister, so what can take a folks nagging? That's before she starts to bragging about how big and fat her middle finger is and stick it right in the face of the society's ugly discrimination and proceed to titillate in the outer cases of your cerebral rooms until she done dropped the boom and you're begging for more of this oral wordplay. But I ain't got but a few minutes left on this stage. But I'll stay. If I can intellectually fondle your G-spot and literally kiss every part of your scarred heart that God must have missed until you get the gist that I pimp poems in the art form of spoken word to maybe start a spark and pick up where our dead martyrs left off. And that's revolution. And if you ain't ready for change, well, I'm glad you came. Because ain't not one of us can wait for 400 years for a damn change to come. That's why I'm glad that freedom, yo, it is not won. It's won by making your oppressors succumb.